Oke, mari kita terus kepada tangen yang sempurna. Jenis tangen sempurna kepada dua bulatan. Kali ini adalah terlibat dua bulatan dan bagaimana kita nak melukiskan tangen yang sempurna kepada dua bulatan ini. Ini juga dapat dari perkara buku teks. If you notice, there are two circles here, dua bulatan. The first one here is the circles sama size lah, bulatan yang mempunyai size atau jari yang sama besar. Jadi kita dapat melukiskan empat tangen, tangen satu, dua, tiga dan empat. Now if the circles are different size yang dalam radius 1b sini. Size kecil dan size besar, besar, kecil, juga kita dapat melukiskan empat tangen. Okay, now ingat, apa yang dilukis di sini akan membina simetri, even if I draw this here. Okay, so you see the triangle they form here. All this will be symmetry lah. It will be symmetry dan berketaran. Nanti kita akan lihat contoh. Alright, next contoh is tangen yang sempurna ialah bila dua bulatan bersentuh macam ni. Jadi tangen yang kita boleh melukiskan ada tiga sajalah. Dan tiga saiz yang sama juga sama, tiga lah. Dan akhirnya, what happen if dia bersilang? Kalau sama saiz, bersilang, contoh ni, ada dua contoh tangen. Kalau tidak sama saiz, juga dua tangen. Kalau ini bersilang dan satu bulatan yang sama, yang besar, yang lebih kecil tu di dalam, then we can only draw one tangen. So, this type of shapes, all this bentuk ya, bentuk-bentuk dalam raja di 7 raja ni, ingatlah the type of tangen you can draw. Okay, so for this drawing thing, then we can look at how we can solve some problem. This is some of the example problem lah from terlibat dua bulatan dan tangen yang sempurna. So di sini ada dua bulatan yang besar tu 4 cm jejari dan kecil 3 cm jejari. Jika nak carikan x, jangan lupa di sini juga 90. It's actually 90 degree bertegak, seranjang. Okay, it's 90 degree. So you want to find x. So there's no way. I mean, the only way to find x is to use the nisbah trigonometry. Here, you can see like this. Okay, 1 cm or 7 cm. Jadi x here will be sebelahan dan bersebelahan dan bertentangan. Okay, so there will be cos, cos. Okay, cos x will be 1/7. So that is how you find the. Oh, it's not 7 cm. It's actually the hypotenuse. Okay, so that's why be careful lah. It sometimes can be confusing. Berhati-hati ya. Okay, now we go to the next contoh. Di sini. We need to find the nilai x. As I said awal tadi, bila ada tangen sempurna dan dua bulatan, we will find something like symmetry. In this case, I know that x will be equal to 130 degree. Even if you don't want to do this, you can always draw a line here. And you can cut this into 65, there will be like 65 over here, 90 degree. If it is 65 here, will be 25. Here will also be 25. Here is 90 degree. Yeah, go back to 65 because it's symmetry. This is also 65. So 65 plus 65 also 130 degree. Yeah, so that's how you do that. Now panjang AM. Panjang AM tentu menggunakan nisbah trigonometri lah. Let's do it. first, huh? Oh, let me draw this first, huh? Yeah. Something like this, huh? So this is 65 degree. This one is 60 m. Here's 90 degree. So here's A and M. So you can look at this here. A and M. Okay. That's all good, huh? Okay, the funny one. Macam ni. Okay, so now I can find AM. To find AM, I can use, because this is bertentangan opposite and bersebelahan, so I can use tangent. Tangent 65 is equal to AM over 6. Jadi, AM is just tangent 65 times 6. Tangent 65 times 6. Okay, 12.87 cm. Okay. Kalau saya nak cari cm, I can use the ratio lah, because ingat kan, semua ini adalah berkadaran dan simetri. Jadi kalau saya AO, okay, kalau saya gunakan berkadaran dua, di antara dua segitiga, okay, saya AM lah. AM over apa ni? AM over 6 means let's say this is AO lah. AM over AO nisbahnya mesti sama dengan CM over CD. CM over CD. Jadi saya nak cari CM. So CM means just AM over AO darab dengan CD. Semua ni ada nilai. AM is 12.87 over AO. AO is apa ni? AO is 6 lah. CD is 4. See? 6 times 4 lah. So I get what? So 12.87 divided by 6 times 4. So I get 8.58. 8.58 cm, so that will be AM. CM. Okay, so what's the next thing to do? Oh, I want to find OD. Okay, OD. In order to find OD, I need to do this. OD is just OM plus MD. OM, OD is just OM plus MD. So OM, I use theorem Pythagoras. 6 square plus 12.87 plus MD. MD is 4 square plus 8.58 square. Okay, so this will give you OD. Let's see what you get. 36 plus 12.87 square. So square root. Okay, let me teach you right. 14.20 plus 4 square plus 8.58 square. Square root dia 9.47. So this will give you 9.47 plus 14.2 23.67. Okay, so this is the answer. Alright. Okay. Now ini jalan kerja oleh cikgu lah. Ini bukan hanya satu jalan kerja saja kan untuk mendapat saya. Kalau saya nak cari OM, I can also use this part trigonometry to find OM. Then sama juga MD ya. But I also can use theorem Pythagoras. So jadi apa yang kita belajar sampai sini ya, semua boleh digunakan since theorem Pythagoras, nisbah trigonometri, dan segitiga yang berkadaran dan konsep simetri, all this can be used to solve this kind of mathematics problem. And with this, we end the chapter here, and we'll do some exercise. Okay, so sekian, terima kasih.